إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد I begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful and the most high, and I send my peace and blessings and salutations upon our final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of the blessings that He Azza wa Jalla has given us. One of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us is the blessing of time. And we know this because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes a qasam, when He takes an oath in the Qur'an, by anything, then it means that the thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking an oath by must be of great significance, must be hugely important. Because in the Qur'an, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by many different things. And one of these, as we know, is by time, wal asr. By time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath showing the significance of this. Now, as believers and as servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how do we best show our shukr and our gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for any blessing that He has given us? Whether it's the blessing of iman, the blessing of wealth, the blessing of family, the blessing of time, the blessing of health, how do we show true shukr and appreciation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Not just verbally, not just with our tongues. This is one level. One level of shukr is with our tongues. It's the bare minimum we can do by saying Alhamdulillah, by saying Ashukru Lillah. This is the bare minimum. But actually what is expected from us as believers is to show shukr through our actions. Through our actions. For example, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with family, then not just saying thank you Allah for this blessing, but actually, you know, giving our family their due right, spending time with them, loving them, caring for them. This is actually the best way of shukr. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you wealth, then not just saying thank you Allah for this wealth, but with our wealth, the way that we spend it, the way that we utilize it, the way that we earn it, that will determine how grateful we are for this blessing. Similarly, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with time, each and every single day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with these minutes and these hours and these days, then the way that we show shukr to Allah is not just by thanking Allah for this verbally, but by making use of the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, by making use of it, by performing more good deeds. That is the best display and show of our shukr and our gratitude to our Creator, Allah Azza wa Jal. Now, on this note of time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us and blessed us with different seasons in the year. The season that we pretty much entered into now is the season of winter, right? It's winter time for us here in the UK. And we can look at this negatively. We can look at this negatively and say, you know what? I don't like winter time because it's really cold. It gets dark too early. The weather's horrible. It's gloomy outside. You know, we can look at it with that perspective, with that outlook. We can have a negative outlook on things. But actually, as believers, we're taught not to be negative. We're taught to be optimistic, not pessimistic. We're taught to be optimistic. And in fact, we should see this as a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why do we see this as a blessing? Because let's look at what our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the winter time. Let's look at what the Sahaba, our pious predecessors, the righteous people of the past, what did they say about the winter time? In fact, there is a famous statement which has been attributed to one of the famous companions, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu an, who used to say, Marhaban bishita. He used to say, Marhaban bishita. He used to say, welcome, When the time of winter would come, he would welcome the season of winter, the time of winter. Why? He would explain. He would say, تَتَنَزَّلُ فِيهِ الْبَرَكَةِ. That in this season, in this particular time of winter, Allah showers and sends down His barakah. The blessings are seen in this time. And he continues and he further elaborates. He says, وَيَطُولُ فِيهِ اللَّيْلُ لِلْقِيَامِ. He says that the night time is longer in the winter, which makes it more conducive for standing in the night time for prayer. And he says, وَيَقْصُرُ فِيهِ النَّهَارُ لِلصِّيَامِ. And likewise, because the nights are longer, the days are shorter, which makes it more conducive for fasting in the day. And therefore, this is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he would welcome the time of winter, to the extent that there are even some narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where he said, الشِّتَاءُ رَبِيعُ الْمُؤْمِنِ. الشِّتَاءُ رَبِيعُ الْمُؤْمِنِ. That the winter time is the season of a believer. The winter time is the season for a believer. This is the best season for a believer, in other words. There are some narrations going to this extent. Now, for us as believers, we must just very quickly reflect, and this is what the khutbah will be on. The time of winter. Instead of seeing it, I can see many of you, you're wrapped up, you're wearing scarves, you're wearing these coats, mashallah, and we need it because it's cold out there. But instead of looking at it negatively, look at it positively. That how can we make use of these next few months in this season of winter? How is it more conducive for a believer? How is it better for a believer? How is it the season of a believer? Ibn Mas'ud, he's already mentioned a few points just in his statement that he made. But let's elaborate it on it further. Like he says, that in the winter time you'd realize that night time kicks in very, very early. Okay? Maghrib time, we know. Shortly after 4 p.m., it's dark. Okay? Isha time, by 6, 7 p.m., you'd finish Isha. Your night begins thereafter. Right? And you have all the way up until Fajr. Now it's like, you know, 5, 6 a.m., subhanAllah. Right? Up until that time, that is your night time. What Ibn Mas'ud is teaching us is that now you have the perfect opportunity. Now it becomes much easier to stand in the night for prayer. We're talking about Qiyamul Layl, we're talking about Tahajjud. Many of us, we desire to stand in the night time for prayer. Many of us. But we know how difficult it is. When we think about Tahajjud, what do we think? We think, subhanAllah, I have to wake up at 3, 4 a.m. in the morning when everyone else is asleep, few hours before work, and I have to pray Tahajjud. I struggle for Fajr. How can I even wake up for Tahajjud? We think like that, right? But let's not forget that the time of Tahajjud begins once you've finished Isha. Once you've prayed your Isha, technically the Tahajjud time has kicked in, right? Though there is a best time, there is a more appropriate time, which is the last portion of the night, the last third of the night. That's the best time to pray, but you can pray Tahajjud at any time. So for those of us who have an intention and we've wanted to pray Tahajjud, and in fact the scholars say that if you really want something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would wake up and make dua at that time. If you really wanted something from Allah, then that is the time where you would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if now, thinking practically, it's very easy. Even if you don't want to wake up, if you want to go to sleep and wake up in the morning, that's fine. But you can still pray Tahajjud. How? By making the niyyah before you go to sleep. Whether that's at 9 p.m., 10 p.m., 11 p.m., midnight, whatever time you sleep, you can make the niyyah after Isha that I want to pray an extra 2 rak'at. Okay, let's leave it at that for the minimum. I want to pray an extra 2 rak'at. The niyyah is Qiyamul Layl for Tahajjud. And you pray, you offer those voluntary units of prayer, and you go to sleep. Guess what? You get the reward of Tahajjud. It's as simple as that. And it's easier because it's winter time. Even, by the way, if you wanted to wake up before Fajr, it's even then it's easier. Because think about what time Fajr is now. Think about what time sunrise is. It's actually more practical for you in the winter time, for us in the winter time, to offer the night prayer. So this is one thing. Tying in with that is just the prayers in general. Look at what time the prayers are. So by the time we finish Jumu'ah, within an hour it's Asr time. An hour of that, it's Maghrib time. Then Isha. There should be no excuse in general I'm talking about. Tahajjud is optional. Let's talk about the fara'id. Let's talk about the compulsory 5 daily prayers. It should become easier for you to offer these prayers as well. It should become easier. Why? Because all of them are within a few hours of each other. All of them are within the daytime. You can pray easily. You can pray Isha easily. And the one that we all struggle with is Salat al-Fajr, right? Salat al-Fajr is a huge struggle for many of us. It's a struggle. But now, in the winter time, you will find that sunrise goes past 7 a.m., 7:30 a.m. Even sometimes it will get closer to 8 a.m. sunrise. What time do we wake up for work? What time do we wake up for work? You're going to wake up for work anyway by 6, 7 a.m. So imagine, subhanAllah, you wake up and it's still Fajr time. You haven't changed anything in your time. It's not like summertime where you had to wake up at 4 a.m. to pray Fajr, go back to sleep again, wake up for work. It's, subhanAllah, it's so much easier where you can wake up the normal time, not changing anything in your timetable, making wudu, performing the Fajr prayer, and then starting your day. This is the best start to the day you could possibly have by praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no better start to the day than remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we are taught to do. So in fact, what we're saying is that praying and offering this Fajr prayer becomes much easier in the winter time. This is a blessing. And like we said, the days are short. Maghrib time, 4 p.m. Compare it to Ramadan when we were fasting. We were used to fasting until what time? 8:30. SubhanAllah, even 9 p.m. we were offering our iftar. We had our suhoor at what? 4 a.m. in the morning. We were fasting for 17, 18 hours straight. Now think about winter time. How many hours? Fajr time, you know, 6 a.m. By the time you've broken your fast, 4 p.m. Easy. Not even 10 hours you're fasting. Compare that to the summertime or back in Ramadan, right? It becomes far more conducive and easy for a believer to fast in the winter time. And we know the sunnah fast, even though it's outside of Ramadan now, the sunnah fast on Mondays and Thursdays. Pick one day in that week. You know what? I want to commit one day in the winter. Once a week, I'm going to fast. What's the max you're going to do? The max is that you just have to skip breakfast. That's it. Skip breakfast and, you know, delay your lunch till 4 p.m. That's it. It's honestly very simple. You'll get used to it. Once a week you do that, you stack up the rewards. We know, subhanAllah, that our deeds are presented on these days. The Prophet ﷺ said that our deeds are presented on these days. On Thursdays is presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you not want your deeds to be presented while you are in the state of fasting? This is what the Prophet ﷺ used to do. So these are the two things, qiyam and siyam. Fasting and standing the night in prayer becomes far, far more easier for us, and praying Fajr, etc., in the winter time. There's a few other things that I will quickly add. A few more things. Now, naturally, in the winter, because of the temperatures and because it's colder, what you will realize is that the struggle and the hardship doubles because it's winter time. So, for example, making wudu might not be very difficult for many of us. Yeah, we just need to turn the tap on and perform ablution, perform the wudu. But in the winter time, you'll find naturally what happens, that even performing wudu becomes difficult because it's cold, right? The water is sometimes cold. It takes a while for it to warm up. Okay, so you offer the wudu and you're feeling cold afterwards. You quickly dry yourself. It's mashaqqa. It's difficulty, right? Similarly, walking to the masjid, it's cold. You have to wrap yourself. Coming for Jumu'ah, coming for any other salah, especially in the night time or Fajr time, it's difficult. All of these things require extra effort in the winter. But do you really think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow your efforts to go unnoticed? Do you really think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the same reward that you were getting in the summer, in winter? No. We know this from the Qur'an. We know this from the Qur'an. We know this from the narrations of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who said, مَا يُصِيبُ الْمُسْلِمَ مِنْ نَصَبٍ وَلَا وَصَبٍ وَلَا هَمٍ وَلَا حَزَنٍ وَلَا أَذًا وَلَا غَمٍ إِلَّا كَفَّرَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِنْ خَطَايَةٍ. The Prophet ﷺ said that there is no category of grief or sadness or pain or sorrow or anxiety. There is not a single type of difficulty that afflicts a believer except that Allah expiates their sins through this, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove some of their sins from their accounts, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them for this. Meaning that even the smallest amount of pain, that pain that you feel because of the cold, because you're doing it for Allah, Allah will double your rewards. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins for this, because of that extra effort that you are making. There's another narration in which the Prophet ﷺ says that even even if there were to be a thorn, a small tiny thorn that pricks a believer, that is a small amount of pain. It's not a huge amount of pain. You feel pain for a second or two and that's it, the pain goes away. But the Prophet ﷺ says that even if it was that small prick of the thorn, a believer is rewarded even for that. Even for that, subhanAllah. So imagine the pain and the struggle that we're going through in the winter time. This will not go unnoticed. In fact, you're doubling your... So why I'm saying this is to change our mindset in the winter time. Change your mindset that instead of seeing it as negative, or I feel like this, I feel that way, see it as, you know what, alhamdulillah, Allah has given me an opportunity and I'm making use of this opportunity to further come closer to my Lord. Last few points, inshallah, which is that charity in the winter time. Now, charity can be given at any time, in any season. Why am I mentioning charity or sadaqah in the winter? Is because now we can actually readjust and rethink where we're giving our charity. In the winter time, who are struggling the most? Who's struggling the most in the winter time? You'll find as you're walking on the streets and as you're feeling cold, walking to the masjid, you will find many people that are sleeping on the streets. You will find many people that don't have homes or shelters. You will find many people that don't have the basic necessities and they're struggling. And imagine, subhanAllah, that is their roof. The streets of London, the streets of Ilford, that... And subhanAllah, I've been to certain places in Ilford and I've seen how many homeless people there are. I've seen it. Just around the corner from here, in this locality. Right? These people, they're sleeping out on the streets. That's their homes. We have, alhamdulillah, even then we have central heating. We have heating at home. We have insulation. We have warm homes to go back to. We have heating in our cars. We're not really out for long, if you think about it. But when it comes to charity, readjust your thinking. Think about these people in the winter time. Think it's an opportunity for me to help out, to give some money, to donate to maybe a night shelter, or even to volunteer my time there, to donate to food banks. Support these initiatives in the winter, because this is again an opportunity. Not only is it an opportunity for us to gain reward, but an opportunity to give something back in our communities. This again is unique in the winter time. You'll find the night shelters, they are open from March up until the end of winter. And then they're closed for a few months in between, and then again they'll reopen again. Why? Because these are the coldest and most difficult times, especially for people who are homeless or people who don't have places where they can take shelter. These are just a few points, my dear brothers and sisters, that we can take on board. Whether it is standing in the night for prayer, which is much shorter for us, which are much longer for us, or fasting during the daylight hours, which is much shorter for us, giving charity, experiencing some difficulty in the winter, we should change our mindset and we should think to ourselves that alhamdulillah, Allah has given me this time. Allah has given me and blessed me with this time in the winter. My way of showing shukr to Him and showing my appreciation for the time that Allah has blessed me with is through my actions, that I am actually going to make the intention to try to fast once a week, once a month even in winter time. I'm going to make the intention that at one point in this winter, I'm going to pray one tahajjud prayer. Even if it means before I go to sleep, I want to do that to gain closeness to Allah, to say at least I've done it. Because remember, this is a prayer that the Prophet ﷺ never missed. He never missed it. So I make that intention. Or I'm going to make an intention to get involved in a local night shelter, or to donate, or I'm going to let's readjust and let's rethink our mindsets, and we should, inshallah, push ourselves in winter even more to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the Prophet ﷺ said, and as Ibn Mas'ud said, that this winter time is the season of a believer, let us make use of it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us a tawfiq, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to make use of this season of winter. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes us from His grateful servants. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to come closer to Him during these times. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us all the best in this life and the best in the hereafter. وأقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Alhamdulillah الذي جعل يوم الجمعة سيد الأيام ولا نعبد ولا نستعين إلا إياه وهو الذي فرض صلاة الجمعة بقوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت نستغفرك اللهم ونتوب إليك اللهم هب لنا عملا صالحا يقربنا إليك ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين في كل مكان اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقيموا الصلاة